Publishing a Python package allows you to share your code with others, but also make it easily installable. You can use this to make your own Python library or CLI application that you'll be able to install with the pip command. In this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through step by step on how you can create a basic Python project that you can publish to the PyPI repository. Once you've published it, you and other people will be able to install this package using pip, and then you can use it as a library or a CLI command. So if that sounds good, let's get started. First, you're going to need a couple of tools in your Python environment. So run this pip command to install setup tools, wheel, and twine, which we will be using as part of this project. Next, you're going to need to create the project structure for your package. So here's an example of that. In this case, I'm calling the project pixegami_hello. So that's going to be the root folder. And inside, I'm going to have another folder with the same name, which is going to be the package that I'll actually publish later on. But outside that folder in the root directory, I've also got a setup.py file and a readme file. In the main.py file, I'm just going to create a simple function, which I'll name hello, and it's just going to print this hello message. So it doesn't really do much at this point, but I just want to see if I can create a package out of that and then use this function. We're also going to need an init file as well in the same directory. So go ahead and create that and put this content in there. Import this hello function we created earlier into this init.py file. And just in case you're not familiar with this, let me explain what it does. The init.py file in a Python package serves two purposes. First of all, it tells Python that the whole directory here should be treated as a package. And second, it controls what's actually available when that package is imported. By actually importing this hello function to the init.py file, you can allow users to directly access that function straight from the package. So this actually looks a lot cleaner and more straightforward when you actually use the package. So this is what it will look like once we've actually published it and we want to use it. Next, we're going to need to configure our setup.py file, which will contain the instructions for how to bundle and publish that package. Here's an example code of how you can structure your setup file. It's going to have the name of your package, which should match your folder name, and it's going to have a version number as well. So you have to make sure that you increment this version number each time you want to publish a new version of this package. And finally, if you have any dependencies that you want your package to use, you can put it in this array as well. Now, there's actually a lot more parameters and options you can add to the setup function, but we'll come back to that later. For now, if you have this file and this basic config, we can move on to the next step, which is actually building our package. This command will generate two distributions for us, a source distribution, which is usually just the Python scripts, and then a wheel distribution. So this usually also contains binaries, which are platform specific. And these archives will have all the necessary files for installing and running the package. Now let's hop over to the code editor and actually give that a shot. So here I've got my root project folder, and inside I've got my actual package folder, which I've called pixegami_hello. And here there is my main.py file with my hello function, which I am importing in this init.py file like this. So this is going to be the package that I will create and distribute and publish. Now outside of that, I've got my setup.py file and my readme file and also my requirements file. But you don't need the readme and the requirements file, so that's just up to you whether you want to include it or not. But the one that you need is this setup file. So here's the code that we saw earlier. It just has the name of the package, version 0.1, and then no dependencies. So it's just going to install on its own. Now let's go ahead and run that setup. And after that's finished, you could see it's created a couple of different directories for us. There's a build folder and a distribution folder. And the important file in here is this wheel file, because this is the one that we can distribute and other people can install. So once you see these files, you're ready to move on to the next step. Now, before you actually publish the files to the online repository, you might want to try installing and testing it locally first, just to make sure it works properly. To do that, you can run pip install directly on this wheel file that we just produced a moment ago. Just make sure to replace this command with the actual name and version of your package if you're trying to follow along. Now, if like me, you're running this and it's already installed, or you just want to refresh the installation, you can also use this force reinstall flag with your pip command. After that, you should see a message saying that this was installed successfully. And if you type pip list, you should see this package show up in your Python environment as well. Now with it installed in your environment, you can create a new folder or a new file completely, and then actually import and use the library that you've just installed. So here I'm gonna import that hello function that we published as part of the package, and then I'm just gonna use it here. And here it doesn't actually know where the package is, we've just installed it into our environment, and that's where it lives right now. And if you run this, you should be able to see this hello message that we prepared earlier as part of this package. Now, if this doesn't work for you for any reason, just make sure that you are using the Python environment that actually has this package. So if you type pip list, you should see that package show up here. And you can also click here as well in VS Code to make sure that you really did select that correct environment. Okay, so this is good if you wanted to make a library package, but what if you actually wanted to use this in your terminal as a command on its own? If you actually want to turn the package into a command line interface or a CLI application, you can also do that. Go back to your setup.py file and specify entry points for your package, and you can do it like in this code example here. This will let you run a command and it will map it to any function you want inside your package. So here I'm going to create a command called pixegami-hello. And by the way, this name can be anything you want. It doesn't have to be related to your package name or your function name at all. And I'm going to map it to the pixegami hello package and the function called hello. And again, just to repeat myself, this works because we've imported that hello function right into the package namespace here. So if you haven't done that, you might have trouble finding that function. Let's go back to our editor and try that out. So here I've just added the entry points. You might also want to bump the version number so that you know that you've installed the version with this command. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to bump it to 0.2. And now let's go back to our terminal and build and install the package again. Now, if you did bump the version number, make sure you also change the wheel file because the version number is usually baked into the name here. So make sure that you're installing the latest version that you just published. With that installed successfully, now let's see if we can actually run this command. So here in my terminal, I'm just going to type pixegami hello and then hit run. And now you can see that I've got that output message directly from my terminal. So here, if you want to create a package that you can run directly from your command line, this is how you can do it. Now that your package is ready, let's take a look at how we can publish it to PyPI. PyPI is a Python package repository, and it's where most of the world's Python packages are hosted. So when you run pip install, this is usually where it gets those packages from. First, you're going to need to go to pypi.org and create a PyPI account. So go ahead and do that first if you haven't already. Once you have that, you can run this command to upload anything in your distribution folder directly to PyPI. And when you run this, it's going to ask for your credentials, which you can enter into the terminal directly, or you can also provide it as an environment variable. This is useful if you want to automate it fully. For example, run it as part of a CI/CD workflow. You can set it like this. The environment variables are called twine username and twine password, and this works with both API tokens or with username password combinations. Once you've run the command to publish the package, you can click on this link to see it. And now you can see it's on the PyPI repository, and here's the command we can use to install it. And now anyone all over the world will be able to use this command to install your Python package. Now this description section is a little bit light, so I'm going to show you a trick I like to use to turn the project's README document into this description content over here. Back in my project, I actually already have a README file that contains all the information about this project. And if you already have that information, it really doesn't make sense to copy all of that for the PyPI project description when you can just reuse it. So let's see how we can do that. Back in your setup file, let's first import all the contents of that README file. I'm storing all the text content of this README file in this description variable. Then inside your setup function, we're going to set this long description parameter to whatever we read from the README file. We're also going to set the long description type to markdown so it knows how to render this properly. With that change, let's now bump our version number up by 1, and now we can build and publish our package again. And now if you go to our latest version, you can see that the project description has been updated with the README file. And now that our package has been successfully published to pip, let's see if we can actually install it from a fresh environment using the pip command directly without referencing our local distribution file. So let's copy this pip install command over here. And here I've opened up my terminal to a new Python environment that doesn't currently have this module. So I'm going to run this pip install command. And let's see if our command actually works. Okay, and that seems to work really well. So now you can see how we create a Python package, publish it to PyPI, and now us or anyone else can install it using pip and then use it directly in our terminal. Now, I probably should mention that if you just want to test your uploads or experiment with this, then PyPI actually has a test endpoint that you should use. I actually recommend doing this instead of uploading to the official public repository, because you don't want to start polluting the public repository with experimental projects. To do that, you'll have to follow these instructions to create a test user, create a test API token, and then make a couple of changes to your distribution command. I'll put a link to this page in the project description so you can check it out if you want to try this. That's going to be all for this tutorial today. Check out the description below for the code or for other useful links. If you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more stuff like this, then let me know in the comments below what type of projects or tutorials you'd want to see covered next. Otherwise, I hope you found this useful, and thank you for watching.